Oh, good morning, everyone. We're back on Route 66.
Well, gee whiz, it looks like we're pretty far away from everything here in Holbrook, Arizona.
Everything that is, except for adventure and excitement.
Listen, a Jedi might not crave these things, but I do.
Today, Holbrook is one of those sleepy little Route 66 towns, but it wasn't always that way, because this was once cowboy country.
Holbrook started with the railroad way back in the day and was once known as the town too tough for women and churches. Teddy Roosevelt got a lot of his rough riders from this area, and back in the day, the cowboys had a thing called the hash knife outfit here. This was a pretty rough and tumble place back in the day. Right here in one of the oldest parts of town, right next to the historic train depot, is a street that's still called Bucket of Blood.
That's for real right there. That's legit.
Weird. Now, Holbrook is way out in the Arizona desert, almost all the way to New Mexico. It's a pretty isolated place back in the day.
That is, it was until Teddy Roosevelt created the Petrified Forest National Monument.
And that's when Holbrook began life as a tourist town. Look at this stuff. There's petrified wood everywhere.
I'll be honest with you, I don't really understand what petrified wood is. I just know that they were ancient trees somehow fossilized.
And now they're basically rocks that look just like chunks of trees.
Huh. You know what? The more I think about it, the more that I have a theory as to how this happened.
It's simple, really. It's the only explanation. An ancient witch must have turned the whole forest to stone.
It's the only possible explanation.
First it was a cowboy town, then visitors started pouring in from the railroad.
And then things really started getting fun when Route 66 came right through downtown Holbrook
and then really transformed the place.
Look at this. This is the old Pow Wow trading post. See, Holbrook sits right on the western edge of what is now the Navajo Nation. So this is a running theme everywhere, not just in Holbrook, but in the surrounding area.
Cowboys and Indians were super popular back in the heyday of Route 66.
I mean, this is really before the space race took off. Every kid still wanted to be a cowboy.
Dude, movies about cowboys and Indians, Western magazines, stories, and comic books about cowboys and Indians, no matter how unrealistic, were all the rage.
So when you got to a place like this where you could buy quote-unquote authentic Indian products, well, some of them really were authentic.
Others were like plastic guns and plastic bows and arrows and stuff that were less authentic.
But when you came to a place like this where Native American Indians actually lived and you were able to get Native American stuff and cowboy and Indian stuff, and more than that, when you were able to stay in a hotel room at one of these places, it was like heaven. It was like going to Disneyland for those kids.
That's really just the beginning though, just the tip of the iceberg, because Holbrook is full of all kinds of wacky stuff.
Lots of the old Route 66 roadside gems are still here. Like last night, for instance, I slept in a wigwam.
Dude, it's actually just as fun as it looks. Go back, I did a whole video about it.
But it's not just old Route 66 motels and cafes bringing people into Holbrook.
There's also a ton of fun pick opportunities.
Ooh, look at this. I'm hardcore, mama, riding my bike into the sunset.
Holbrook is still the closest town to the Petrified Forest National Park.
So visitors from all over the world are still coming here to check out why Holbrook rocks so much.
Dang, look at this one here. You can really see the bark. You can see the tree rings. That's crazy. So petrified wood is sometimes millions of years old, right?
I'm actually not that well versed in petrified wood, so I don't know how old it is exactly, but millions of years old, right? And what does millions of years old make people think of?
Well, I don't know about you, but it makes me think of dinosaurs.
And Holbrook has a lot of dinosaurs.
Check this out. The Indian Rock Shop, or the Rainbow Rock Shop, depending on which sign you pay attention to, is easily the most eye-catching sight along this part of Route 66. Look at all of these freaking dinosaurs out here. These things are awesome.
If you've ever done any traveling in the American Southwest, you know that anywhere where there's petrified wood, there's bound to be a big concrete or fiberglass dinosaur.
If there's one thing we love as Americans, it's our big dinosaurs. What are you gonna do?
Now, because there are and have been so many dinosaurs scattered around the Southwest like this, it's likely that these were collected from other roadside stops that have closed.
Because it definitely looks like some of these dinosaurs were moved here. But these are freaking awesome. Actually, it looks like this used to be
two separate shops that are now combined into one. I love all of this stuff. I love all these hand-painted signs like this. I mean, these are old, man. That's classic American roadside signage right there. Almost as old as the petrified wood. And around behind the dinosaurs on this building hidden by the trees over here, you can still see what's left of an old dinosaur mural back there. And there's all these hand-painted touches, like these posts that are painted like the petrified wood. See, I love stuff like that. I love getting out of the house and finding things like this. Ooh, look at this. That seems like a heck of a deal. I mean, I'm no geologist, so don't quote me on that. Do you know, people always think of dinosaurs as these giant, mean, heartless lizards, but that couldn't be further from the truth. Look at this mama dinosaur right here. She's protecting her little babies. Aww. Cute little baby dinosaurs and cute little baby dinosaur barbed wire. Look at these dinosaurs. I love looking at stuff like this. Man, amazing.
Those of you familiar with Walt Disney World are probably thinking what I'm thinking, but this seems pretty familiar.
All these little shops with dinosaurs like this remind me a lot of Dinoland USA at Animal Kingdom.
I think it's pretty safe to say that the Disney Imagineers came to Holbrook and got some inspiration, huh?
It just occurred to me that I've never owned a piece of petrified wood.
Huh. Well, that might all change today, huh? Look at this. Look at all the piles of petrified wood.
Dude, you guys, this place is amazing. Look at all the geodes right here. You got geodes for days. Oh, look at this. Geodes came from the center of the earth, blown out of a volcano as a bubble. It fell to the ground and was buried by volcanic ash. Siliconic quartz seeping through the earth over millions of years filled the bubble with beautiful crystals.
Geodes are bubbles?
Bubbles, 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 bubbles. Dang, that's an epic amount of petrified wood at this place.
If you were to turn the picture black and white, it would just look like a wood pile. But this is all made of rocks. It's all crystalline and shiny and whatnot.
It's crazy how colorful it is. To think, these were once ancient dinosaur food trees.
Look at that, look at the colors in this branch.
I don't know if it's just staining from the dirt or what, but it's weird how the outside still has the color almost of bark.
All right, I'm gonna go inside, see what I can see.
Wow.
Turns out petrified wood is more pricey than I thought. Look at all this different stuff out here.
Skulls and marbles and this piece of wood right here that I was looking at before. $16.
Dude, imagine if this guy sold all this stuff at that same sort of rate. He would be rich.
I think these are what they call desert roses. $150 each. Don't mind if I do.
Okay, I did it. I purchased some petrified wood.
And I found out from the owner of the place, who's been in business for 40 some odd years, he says,
that according to him, all these dinosaurs are locals, they are natives, they built them all themselves in the back.
So here you have an original Route 66 roadside wonder, still in operation by the original owner
who created these amazing roadside dinosaurs
and this amazing fun pick opportunity here.
Although this particular fun pick is oddly fenced in, so we can't use it. We can get a pick next to the fun pick. Ah, cheese.
That is freaking amazing.
There's just something about old hand-painted signs that I cannot get enough of. I wish I could buy these signs off the guy, you know? It'd be better than having a geode.
I've been looking around for old hand-painted Route 66 signs like on eBay or something, or an old authentic Route 66 shield. Nothing doing.
Can't find any anywhere like eBay or anything like that. And if you do find them in an antique shop, they are boy howdy expensive.
I didn't know petrified wood was so expensive either. I was thinking to myself, man, maybe I can buy a whole stump and give it to my mom.
I don't even know what the heck one of these giant ones would cost.
You know that giant petrified stump that Walt Disney had at Disneyland?
He purchased that from a business like this out in Colorado, I think, and gave it to his wife as an anniversary present. I always used to think, Walt, you old cheapskate, buying your wife a rock.
Turns out this stuff is more expensive than diamonds. Jeez Louise!
I was just about to drive away when I saw this.
That right there is the owner of the business coming outside, picking up trash in the parking lot and out on the sidewalk in front of his business. That is old school right there.
That's pretty much a fine example of why anything on Route 66 still survives. Because there are still old school dudes like that who have creativity, who do all this stuff themselves, and still take a lot of pride in owning their business and a lot of pride in their communities.
The paint may be peeling a little bit, but the spirit of the Mother Road is still alive.
Well, I guess I could have comparison shopped a little, because
That place was not the only game in town.
And I know somewhere out there there's a petrified wood expert going, "No, you paid too much for that piece of petrified wood." Here's the thing. If I can give that guy $20 or $30, which I know some of you are sitting out there just like me for 99% of my life going, $20 or $30 is more money than I've ever seen.
But if I can give that guy $20 or $30 and keep his business open, I'm definitely going to do it. That's what Route 66 is all about.
People are cool to me and support me in all kinds of ways. T-shirts and Patreon. They donate $1 a month or $10 a month or whatever it is. Keep the videos coming.
To me, it's the least I can do to pay it forward to a mom and pop business like that.
But it doesn't hurt to come look at the bigger businesses either.
Look at all that. None of that's even for sale. That's all for display. Look at this stuff right here. What have they done? Holy moly.
Get it? Never mind.
Well, I like this. I like this right here. It's one of those tortoise gang members.
Never pick these guys up, no matter how hard they hitchhike. Do not pick up a desert tortoise.
They'll gut you every time. Look at this old car. That's so cool.
What is that, like a Model A Roadster or something? See, I don't even know really how to tell the difference. That's just my uneducated guess. Model A? Question mark? Am I right?
Let's see what's inside. Whoa.
It's a lot different from the last shop.
These places are all very competitive in their pricing, so I gotta be careful not to film too much in here. But look at this. Look at all the fossils.
Are these here, what I think they are?
Like, are those dinosaur?
Never mind. We'll talk about it when you're older.
Dude, ancient seashells. Look at these fossils everywhere.
Look at this. Look at this. They have dinosaur bones in here. And a fossilized alligator named Wild Bill.
He's 2.9 million years old.
Where did you dig up that old fossil?
Dude, look at all of this stuff. Look at the stuff they make out of the petrified wood.
You ever met anyone with a petrified wood coffee table? I haven't.
Look, in here, in all this glass, all of this stuff is their private collection. It's their little museum.
Look at these ones have names. Like that one's Ziggy right there. This one's Happy Sun.
There's the Happy Bat.
The Fly.
Cowboy Boots.
Question mark?
Here is apparently what is some very rare green petrified wood.
Dude, it's crazy. People are really into this stuff.
There's a meteorite from Canyon Diablo, which I believe is where Two Guns, Arizona is.
We went there in a previous video. Look at all these old magazines.
Dude, whoever owns this place is pretty serious about all this stuff.
Look, and they have a crazy collection of old toys. Now that's more up my alley.
Dang, I love stuff like this. This just proves that you can't judge a book by its cover. From the outside, I just thought this would be like any other typical truck stop trading post.
But no, this place is amazing.
It's massive and full of way more personal stuff than I thought. Also, there are more waterfalls than I was expecting.
It turns out the petrified wood makes the perfect waterfall.
Now, of course, though, all I can think about is how expensive this would be to build.
There's turtles in here.
Ooh, look over here, look at these. No, 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 no.
Oh, what the heck?
Not into it.
Ooh. This is cool, though.
A preserved bat.
I don't think I could talk anyone into letting me have that on my wall, but if I could, I would.
This is cool. They have these signs over here telling the story of how they get all this stuff.
It says they purchase petrified wood rights similar to mineral rights from a land company.
We dig for the petrified wood, haul it, clean it, separate it by quality, cut it, wash it, polish it.
Oh, I guess it takes like a billion hours to polish it and to cut it and to get it all perfect like that.
I never knew you had to dig for petrified wood. Huh. I learned something new today.
Dang, they have all these rocks and minerals. I like these ones. They look like fruity pebbles.
Maybe that's where they got the idea for fruity pebbles. Now, for the backyard. Look at this. Dang, that's a lot of sand roses out here.
Look at these things.
They're beautiful.
I've had stuff like this explained to me a million times. Like, oh, the crystals are formed over pressure, time, blah, blah, blah. My mind is not wax geological. I just have to look at it and go, pretty.
Whoa, here they got some strange wooden ball thingies. Those are cool. And there's just all kinds of stuff out here. Sandstone and flagstones and quartz.
Dude, look at this stuff here. This ice rock. I've never seen anything like that. Selenite, selenite. You can pretty much see through this. Like, it just looks like chunks of glass. That's cool.
Oh, I see. The price would change a lot depending on the color of the petrified wood, too.
Dude, look at all this obsidian. You could make a lot of arrowheads out of that.
They got cactus wood and volcanic rock,
zebra rock,
rhyolite,
Utah Wonderstone.
I wonder why they call it that.
Ironwood,
green quartz,
the biggest pile of geodes I've ever seen,
and best of all, coprolite. Dino dung.
Do you think this is really dinosaur dung, or is that just a clever name?
Because if this is actually dinosaur dung,
then I've got poop all over my hands! Oh, poopy!
Ew, disgusting, dinosaur poop!
Dang. Pretty cool. This place really rocks!
I am never gonna get tired of that joke.
Well, that was mind-blowingly cool. Jim Gray's Petrified Wood Company.
I've never actually been out to the national park, you know, the Petrified Forest National Park. I do have my annual pass for the national parks, but it's already getting kind of late, and I kind of want to save something so I have an excuse to come back to Holbrook.
So it looks like the park and I are going to tango another day.
Yeah, pretty much got to be headed back home now, but I still have one more thing I want to see in town before I go.
Gonna real quickly poke my head into the old Navajo County Courthouse.
The other day, they gave me this Route 66 passport at the El Trovador.
It's the last stop in the book, but I'm hoping to get my first stamp here.
Dang, this building was built in 1898.
Look at the size of it.
You know, back then people were living in these little rock huts and adobe brick buildings. This must have looked massive, like a friggin' castle.
It's definitely showing its age a little bit. This is pretty cool.
Ooh, turn handle.
Oh, okay.
Hello. Hello.
Yeah, I have to get my passport stamped.
Look at that.
Okay.
This place is huge. Upstairs first.
Look at the size of this place.
It's like a palace in here.
Seriously, I think the last place that I was in with ceilings this high was the Louvre.
Oh. It's the old courthouse. The courtroom is upstairs.
Look at this.
This is where you had to come defend yourself before they lynched you.
Whoa. Look at that.
I feel like the king of everything up here.
You can totally come sit in the judge's seat, but you are not allowed to sit in the jury seats.
They are too old and brittle.
Do not enter the historical area, please.
Look at this. Vote for W. Dean Nutting.
What you running for, W. Dean? Nutting.
Dude, this place is cool.
I guess this guy, Sheriff Owens, who's pretty famous, like along the lines of Wyatt Earp or something like that,
went to go arrest a guy named Andy Cooper
at someone named John Blevin's house
and ended up shooting like a crap ton of people.
I don't know much about Sheriff Owens or the Blevins,
but I love seeing stuff like that because seeing stuff like that makes me want to know.
Okay, time to enter the judge's chambers here.
Look at all this stuff.
Huh.
An old Wild West judge's chambers.
Here we have the judge's library. Good thing he has this book, Tin and Its Uses. That's gonna come in handy.
So weird, there's a bedroom in there. Check out all this stuff.
Whoa, tale as old as time.
Beauty and the Beast library status.
Huh,
this is where people used to come to get their marriage licenses.
Oh, what the heck is that?
I was not expecting to see a guy mounted on horseback upstairs in the courthouse. What you boys up to?
Ah, these guys are from the Hash Knife Gang. They became Pony Express riders.
I guess a hash knife is that symbol right there, an old cattle brand.
I'm still kind of fuzzy on the whole Hash Knife Gang, Hash Knife Pony Express thing. Are they related? Are they different?
All I know is that there's a horse upstairs in the old courthouse.
And that is something that I can get behind.
Oh, it's the jury room here.
Whoa, they got some old World War II stuff. Look, there's the Hitler Dead newspaper. There's an old Hitler pincushion. Look at that.
I don't want this to sound weird, but I want a Hitler pincushion.
Look where you stick the pins. Yay, yay, yay.
Oh, check this out. Here's a shield from the CCC, the Civilian Conservation Corps.
They built a lot of the infrastructure at our national parks. My grandfather was a member of the CCC.
It was one of those FDR New Deal programs where the guys got paid a dollar a day. They got food and lodging,
got to send that dollar a day home, and then they did raw manual labor out constructing all kinds of public works.
Not a lot of people even know what the Triple C's, the CCC, even was.
My grandpa was in a CCC camp in Home, Pennsylvania.
Yeah, I've never been out there to see the camp. I don't know if it even still exists, but it's pretty cool. Pretty cool stuff.
Boy, they got a lot of typewriters and recording equipment in here.
That makes sense for a courthouse, but the cash register? Huh. Maybe that's where they paid your bail.
Okay. Let's see what's downstairs. This place is huge. It's like a maze.
Oh, here we have some exhibits about the Native Americans.
Here are some of the indigenous inhabitants of the region.
Huh, and some of the different tribes. Havasupai, Navajo, White Mountains, Apache, Yavapai.
Ooh, authentic adobe bricks.
Oh, here's displays about the Hopi.
And even a Hispanic display.
Ooh, spicy.
Native American arrowheads and pottery.
Oh, what the heck is this?
Oh, this is an old chuck wagon.
These are the old food wagons that would follow the cowboys and feed the whole gang.
I shouldn't have a hankering for chili.
I've always heard the expression chuck wagon, but I've never actually seen a real chuck wagon. So that's cool.
Oh, here's the post office.
I wonder if the post office was actually in this building or they just took this from another building for the display.
Either way, I wish my P.O. box looked like this. That's awesome.
Hmm, there's a display about radio stuff, and there's some old glass insulators up there.
I still really don't understand what they're for.
I just know that wire used to get wrapped around them.
Dang, I thought I was just gonna poke my head in here really quick. But there's so much stuff. Look at this safe. I've never seen a round safe like this. That's cool.
Very, very bizarre.
Whoa. It just doesn't end. This is crazy.
This display reminds us that there didn't used to be television or computers. If you wanted to be entertained, you had to sit around with your family and make music yourself.
Or, you know, buy a turntable or a radio.
Yeah, and you had to make your own food and do your own dishes and grind your own coffee
and vacuum your own floor.
That might be the oldest vacuum cleaner I've ever seen.
When I woke up this morning in a wigwam, I had no idea that I would see the oldest vacuum cleaner I've ever seen.
Oh, or the oldest refrigerator. Oh, here's a bunch of information about some of the older buildings in town. The original movie theaters.
This is about the old Bucket of Blood Saloon. The original Bucket of Blood Saloon.
I guess it was originally named The Cottage.
But some cowboys shot a couple of Mexicans and they said it looked like there was a bucket of blood spilled all over the floor.
Perfect excuse for renaming your business.
Ooh, old toys. Cool.
Ooh, and old liquor bottles. Ooh, Seagrams? Schnapps?
Cattle brands and tools and locks and bicycle pumps? Weird.
Here's some old cameras.
There's the office for the Historical Society.
I keep hearing a lot of footsteps, muffled voices, and banging over here.
Either someone's locked in these offices, or this place is haunted.
I have this weird feeling that around any corner, I'm gonna run into Sloth from the Goonies.
Oh, these are cool. Look! Mountain Dew.
Okay, definitely running out of time now.
Last but not least, I gotta come back down by the front door
and head over this way
to the old county jail.
Looks like this was the old sheriff's department here inside the courthouse building. Look at this though.
Dude, what the heck? Ooh, look at this jail art.
Ooh, watch your step.
Look at this. This is how you used to open the cell doors with these huge levers.
It is way more than a little bit freaky down here.
Oh!
This room clearly used to go way farther back than we're allowed to go now.
Look, you can see inside of the cell block there.
Whoa, holy cow. I would not have wanted to break the law in Holbrook.
This is the freakiest part over here. Look at the old jail toilet. That's brutal. Would not want to poop there. No, sir.
Well, the sink is right over the toilet seat. Well, that's convenient, I guess.
Oh, look at that old keyhole right there. Creepy.
I don't know when they stopped using this as their jail, but I wonder if any of this graffiti dates back to the inmate times.
Man, look at some of the art on the walls in here. That's pretty cool. A lot of names, a lot of graffiti. Crazy Legs was here on December 4th, 1976.
Oh, good old Crazy Legs.
Yeah, most of this stuff has dates on it from 71, 72 through about 1976. So I'm gonna go ahead and guess that's around the time that this became not a jail anymore.
Yeesh.
Good times.
Oh.
Jeez Louise, I've been to Alcatraz, but for some reason, this place is creepier.
I mean, you got locked up here. You got locked up.
It does not look that comfortable.
Oh yeah, right here, duh. This jail was last used in 1976.
1976? A bunch of our parents and grandparents could have been locked up in there.
The jail was shipped here as a unit from St. Louis and installed in 1898 when they built the courthouse. That's gnarly.
Hard to see because it's kind of dark, but there's a picture of the sheriff right there.
Sitting about here in front of those doors.
And the picture is dated January 1920?
In the corner it says 1919, but either way, almost 100 years ago, the sheriff was chilling right there, guarding the jail.
Oh, there's all these newspapers about John F. Kennedy being killed here in the sheriff's office for some reason. It's kind of weird.
Dang, there's the Navajo County Sheriff's Hash Knife Posse shirt.
Can you imagine wearing that outfit to work?
That's one crazy ensemble there.
All right, gotta go to the bathroom. And of course the bathrooms are located in the creepy part of the building.
I wouldn't normally film inside a bathroom, but I wanted to show you guys this piece of poetry here. I still stand grand, built in 1898. My history is first rate, but my plumbing is out of date. It means a bit of a wait before another flush. Oh, great.
Hey, man, anything as long as I don't have to use the toilet in the jail.
Oh. Hey, what's this? A hat hook?
Oh, a peephole. Look at this, it's a peephole for the sheriff to look into the jail.
Look at that. Look at that in there.
Dude.
Do you guys realize what this means about the sheriff?
It's a peeping Tom.
Crazy. Here is the jail's old record book from back in the 1890s. See that name right there, George Smiley?
He was sentenced to hang to death, and the sheriff at the time sent out invitations inviting people.
Apparently, the president and the governor didn't think that was appropriate and said that they were not proper.
So the sheriff sent out a second round of invitations with more proper wording.
Oh, and George Smiley ended up being hung right outside the courthouse.
Ooh.
A man was hanged out here.
Do you think people made a lot of jokes like, guess old George Smiley isn't smiling no more, stuff like that?
All I know is, that's as much time in jail as I ever want to spend. Who the
hell? Well, okay, I got my passport stamped and learned a lot more about Holbrook than I ever thought I would.
Guess it's time to do as the Route 66 pioneers did and start heading back west to California.
Good times. I love museums like that.
Well, so long, Holbrook. I didn't actually see half of what I thought I was gonna get to see today.
And yet I'm still leaving 2 hours after I thought I was going to.
Pretty freaking awesome town.
Definitely gonna be coming back here.
You may leave. And you may win, but you will never be here again. So open up, boy, and climb on in and take it easy.
You know what? That reminds me. Since we're headed back west, we need to do something.
You probably already figured out where I was going with this. We gotta stop off in historic Winslow, Arizona.
Normally I'd go right to standing on the corner in Winslow, Arizona.
But this time I got my Route 66 passport, which I'm supposed to get stamped in here.
Winslow stamped must be obtained in the historic Hubble Trading Post.
I've probably driven past this building a dozen times in my life and never even noticed it.
The Lorenzo Hubble Company. Look at that. You can see all that ghost riding up there. That's awesome.
Until today, I was unaware that Winslow even had a visitor center.
Gotta get this sucker stamped.
Here we go.
Wow. Only one other one.
Yay, I got the stamp. Got
there's a standing on the corner stamp?
Yes, that's awesome.
Sweet.
Home of the world's largest Navajo rug, huh? Is it still here?
Our Winslow Arch Trust has purchased it.
Oh, so it's still in town somewhere.
Yeah.
That's cool. I didn't know there was so much historical information to be had about Winslow.
Okay, I got the stamp.
Now it's time to make it good.
Time to head on downtown.
So I can stand on the corner in Winslow, Arizona.
Yeah, we've been here before, but this time it's serious. I got a stamp for crying out loud.
All right, here it is. The big moment.
This is really happening. We're doing it. Here we are. Standing on the corner.
Wow. We earned our stamp. Sweet.
Oh my gosh, it's the flatbed Ford.
Oh, no girl inside. Lame. I love this place. It's the one spot in town where you know you can take it easy.
Someone once told me that all told, all combined, the Eagles have sold more records than anybody else.
That sounds suspicious to me. The Eagles? More than the Beatles? More than Michael Jackson even? The Eagles. Is that true?
Supposedly, the biggest band in the world. I don't know.
I mean, they do have some toe tappers, so maybe.
Oh, yeah, man. Take it easy, brother.
Ugh, a lot of driving today. Just been humming to myself. You know, get your kicks on Route 66. Gallup, New Mexico. Flagstaff, Arizona. Don't forget Winona. Winona!
Dang, we almost forgot about Winona!
You want to know how come every time you see a Route 66 video, you don't really hear anything about Winona?
Well, let me show you why not. It's because this is pretty much all there is to it. Winona, Arizona, everybody.
Other than having some pretty wildflowers and being in the Route 66 song, there's really not much to it.
Matter of fact, I'm pretty sure it's only in the song because Winona rhymes with Arizona. It's even out of order. Gallup, New Mexico, Flagstaff, Arizona, and then you back up to not forget Winona.
Not sure what the modern population is, but judging by my drive through town, there are more goats here than people in Winona, Arizona.
I keep almost wanting to say Winslow.
The one cool thing about Winona when you pull over is that there's this old piece of Route 66 off the modern old Route 66 that leads over here to this abandoned bridge.
The song may not have forgotten about Winona, but time sure has.
This bridge is pretty beautiful. Look at it. Just sitting out here, minding its own business. Once, this was the crossing point for thousands and thousands of travelers on the old Mother Road.
Check it out, the bridge in Winona is even on the National Register of Historic Places. Maybe that's why it hasn't been demolished yet.
It's getting a little windy and rainy out here.
Raindrops are falling on my face.
Well, there's no trading posts or hokey Route 66 restaurants or Wigwam Motels or anything here, but it's not every day that you get to walk out on an old abandoned bridge.
There you go,
we did it.
The old bridge has been crossed.
The new bridge doesn't look all that much bigger than the old bridge, probably a little wider. No height restriction for trucks, I guess. What a trip to be on this old portion of Route 66. Also, what a trip to be friggin' shivering out here after it's been like 100 degrees all week.
All right, Flagstaff, Arizona, just up there in the mountains. A little more driving to do.
Hang on. Hey mom, guess what? I didn't forget Winona! You know what's funny is I just found out that Winona Judd actually came up with her name, because that's not her real name, from the lyrics to the Route 66 song. So Winona Judd is named after this place. Don't get me wrong, it's beautiful out here, but there is not a lot going on, believe me.
Oof.
Well, I hope you guys are prepared for what's up next.
This is the high point of our adventure.
We made it to Flagstaff, Arizona, and it's the high point because Flagstaff has the highest elevation of any town on Route 66 at 7,000 feet.
And the reason that I know that's the case is because in the Arizona Route 66 passport, it's a fun fact.
What a fun one. And that's the only reason I'm stopping in Flagstaff at all, is to get at least one more stamp in my passport today.
I don't care if the prize ends up being a rubber pencil topper or something. I want it. Ooh la la. Ta-da. Well, that was easy. Look at this right here. An inflatable Route 66 shield.
I love stuff like this. Old train depot becomes visitor center and still a train station.
And gift shop and fun pick opportunity and place to get your cheesy tourist passport stamps.
I've driven through Flagstaff plenty of times in my life. I've even slept here plenty of times. But I've never really explored the old town.
And today, I'm not gonna. I achieved my mission. I went and stayed in the Wigwam in Holbrook, and now I've done my duty, and I've got to go home and sleep well.
So this is where I leave you guys today, in Flagstaff, Arizona, on the side of the railroad tracks.
If you like these videos, consider donating $1 a month or more to patreon.com/justinscard. Get one of my sweet hats, the R stands for adventure, or t-shirts at livefastlifepoortoutspreadshirt.com. I got social media and all kinds of stuff. Down below in the description, there'll be some links.
Subscribe for some more adventures, and I'll see you guys in random land.
Oh, no, you guys stay here. Oh, don't worry, I'm sure some hobos will come along with the railroad and teach you guys the ropes.
Ignore that ominous thunder, you guys will be fine.
Whew. All right, guys, stay safe, and hopefully if you subscribed, I'll catch you a little later, all right? Bye-bye. What are you guys doing? I was kidding. Come on. I was kidding. Get in the car. Come on, you silly goose. Let's go.